What's up, everyone? Welcome to another episode of Eric's Garage. With today, I got a new project I'm excited to show y'all. Let's get it unloaded and put it in the shop. So this here is a 1971 or 72 CB450 twin. A family friend basically gave this to me. And I'm going to try to get it back up and running. It was his father-in-law's motorcycle. He inherited it and decided he didn't have time for it. So here it is. It's mostly complete. I do have the side covers. From what I've been told, this bike was originally green. So I'm assuming it was that dark green that they had on these back in the 70s. It is not locked up. It does spin over. I am missing the key, which I should be getting soon, along with the paperwork. But for the most part, it's complete. It's got surface rust all over. It's got some corrosion on the engine. Not sure about these carburetors. I'm gonna pop the bowls off here in a minute and see what we're working with and decide if we're gonna keep these or switch over to a dual Mikuni setup. It does need new tires. I'm gonna go ahead and rebuild the forks and basically just give this thing a once over. I'm not sure what the plans are for this bike. If we're going to keep it stock or do a cafe bike or a brat style bike, I'm not sure, but just giving y'all a little once over here. Shows that I have only 8,906 miles, but the Speedo drive cable's broke, so no telling how many miles this thing has. I'm gonna go ahead and get this float bowl off and see what we're working with. As you can see, somebody tried to seal this with RTV, silicone, whatever you want to call it, but we will pop this off and see what we're working with here, if we can get it off. This is something you don't do on a carburetor, is put silicone on it. Ain't that nice? Here, let's see if we can get it to come off. There we go. All right, it's not terrible. This one is missing the needle, which is strange. The needle's gone. Interesting. All right. I'm just trying to assess these carburetors so we can see if these are even feasible to rebuild. So I'm just trying to do a little quick inspection before I pull them off and waste my time. Let's see if I can get this off. Thank you. I'm mainly trying to inspect. So I'm mainly trying to inspect the tolerance on this, because this doesn't have a diaphragm. It's just a machine fit. So I'm just trying to see if, which I mean, it does pull a vacuum, so these might be all right. Put our screws back in, and then we'll talk about what we're going to do here, potentially. All right, so judging by the status of the carburetors, this one is missing the float needle, the needle and seat, you know, it's gone. Not sure what we're gonna do here. I'm gonna look up how much these carburetor rebuilds kits cost and kind of price everything out and see what we're gonna go from there. Because I'm gonna try to copy what I did on my CB360, which I'm gonna show you out here in a second. So this here is the first bike I did. This is a 74 CB360 that I bought a few years ago and did up. I'm currently in the process of fixing a timing issue. So when I got this bike running, it never really ran 100% right. It always had like a weird kind of high idle issue, and I kept taking apart the carbs, rebuilding them. Did whatever I could, it would not go away. And then one day I just happened to look at this and realized this is the wrong spark advancer in here. This is actually for a CB350. And apparently there's a different spring rate and all that stuff. So I have the right one to put in here. I just haven't had time to do it. So I'm gonna do a video on retiming this engine, putting the proper spark advance in there, setting up the points, all that stuff. But this is the first bike I did. I made this exhaust, this 2-into-1 exhaust here, with nothing but an angle grinder and a cheap Harbor Freight welding machine. If I could have done something differently, I'd have put some flexible joints in here to make this easier to get on and off. Rebuilt the forks, rebuilt the brakes. I wired this bike myself. I had a buddy of mine make the seat. I made this battery box, electrical tray. It's got, this bike's kick only, so it's just got a little 4-cell battery in it, anti-gravity battery. Got a sweet little cone muffler on here. But it's a cool little bike. I think for the 450, I do wanna do more of a cafe style bike. There's a fella on the internet that makes it's basically a seat like this, but it's also got a detachable, like, cafe racer style cowl that goes on the back. I really like that. I think it's pretty trick. So we're going to go ahead, and I think we're going to go with that style seat on that bike. and pretty much that'd probably be it for that bike, other than just doing all the regular mechanical stuff. But I'm gonna do a video on this bike too as well. I just wanted to show y'all this bike and kind of get y'all hyped up about it, maybe get some ideas on what to do. I've never really messed with the 450s. I've only messed with the 350s and the 360. But I mean, this seems like a solid bike. And yeah, let me know what y'all think. Thanks for checking out this video. If y'all want to see more, let me know. If y'all have any ideas on what I should do with the 450, comment down below. Appreciate it. See y'all in the next one. Bye.